Good day to Dinarians on the go and in the know, October 22, 2019, no hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, Musawi, Suhail, Alawi and Chukri. The most prominent candidates for the presidency of the alternative government after the resignation of Abdul Mahdi, Monday, October 21, 2019, 14:15 p.m. Baghdad Sky Press, the political analyst and head of the Iraq Foundation for Relations and Media, Sadiq al-Musawi, put forward three names to head the government of national rescue will be announced after the resignation of the current Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi expected next Thursday. Musawi said in a tweet that a brief of dialogues on decisions to calm the demonstrators resulted in the option of offering an alternative government for 1 year to create the atmosphere for early elections, and the formation of a committee to amend the constitution. Musawi said in his Twitter that the candidates for prime minister are Ali Alawi as Najaf wants, and Ali Shukri supported by Mr. Makada al-Sadr. While the head of the Coalition of State Law Nuri al-Maliki to assign the task to the Minister of Higher Education Qusay al-Suhail, noting that several other names are still put in the ongoing dialogues. It was reported that the political blocs reached an agreement on the resignation of the government of Adel Abdul Mahdi this weekend and put forward an alternative government is arranged for early elections under international supervision in an attempt to absorb the anger of the street and resolve the crisis between protesters and ruling parties. Next article of interest. The Association of Private Banks organizes a course framework for corporate information technology governance and management, 21st October, 2019. The Association of Iraqi Private Banks, on Monday, in cooperation with the Information Systems Audit and Control Association ISACA, organized a course framework for corporate information technology governance and management. The course program aims to introduce participants to IT management issues, challenges affecting companies, and key concepts of the new process evaluation model. The course is aimed at IT managers, assistants, IT department staff, IT systems auditors, risk and compliance managers and IT systems governance specialists. Next article of interest. Sorry, no decision to postpone the session after the demonstrations will be held Wednesday, October 21, 2019, 2029. The head of the opposition parliamentary wisdom bloc, Fayal al-Sari, denied the news that the parliament session scheduled for next Wednesday will be postponed until after the popular demonstrations planned for next Friday. Al-Sari said for the Afridis, there is no decision to postpone the meeting after the demonstrations and there are requests for more than 117 deputies and we are still in Baghdad as a bloc of wisdom are present in the rest of the political blocs and the meeting will be held on Wednesday and there is an insistence by the deputies to hold it. He stressed, there is no decision at the presidency of the parliament or the political blocs and the parliament to postpone the meeting and all that is happening now is to communicate with the heads of blocs and deputies to hold the meeting on time to manage the status of demonstrations and the demands of the demonstrators, which arrived in parliament and the government's actions and follow-up and investigation. Holding the meeting is an urgent necessity before Friday, Sari said. Next article of interest. Will Barzani intervene to save Abdul Mahdi's government? 22nd October, 2019. Kurdistan Democratic Party MP Dana Mohammed Al-Kaid confirmed that the president of the Kurdistan region of Iraq Masoud Barzani is able to intervene to save the government of Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi, noting that the current government does not bear the mistakes of previous governments. The writer said in televised comments followed by information, that the party president Masoud Barzani is able to help the blocs in the rescue of the government because of its political influence, indicating that his party will not stand against any project contributes to calm the street. He added, what the people demand is the outcome of crises of 15 years and cannot hold the government mistakes of previous governments, pointing out that the weakness or strength of Abdul Mahdi is dependent on the support of the blocs him. On the calls for early parliamentary elections, the writer saw that there is no point in the early elections because the blocs themselves will compete in them. Next article of interest. A new generation of protesters is shaking the pillars of power in Iraq. October 22, 2019 Baghdad. Baghdad, Iraq's unprecedented protest movement, though severely repressed by the authorities, has the advantage of redrawing attention to the shortcomings of the political process and the corruption of a regime that is beginning to feel the danger of its continuation and contemplating how to save it. The popular circles are preparing to complete the march of protests until reaching radical solutions, where it is supposed to start popular demonstrations on the 25th of this month in Baghdad and a number of Iraqi provinces to demand better services in Baghdad and other cities. Calls and tweets spread through social networks in Iraq to prepare for these demonstrations, while the National Security Council called in an extraordinary session chaired by Prime Minister General Commander of the Armed Forces Adel Abdul Mahdi to speed up the processing of law enforcement forces recently formed by the Iraqi government to confront the demonstrators instead of the army police used excessive force against demonstrators using live bullets, tear gas, sticks and batons, killing 108 protesters and wounding 6,100 others, including security personnel. Iraqi politicians and lawmakers say Iraqi President Bahram Saleh is on track to deal with popular demonstrations against the political system and corruption, far from plans by Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi and Parliament Speaker Mohammed Al-Albasi, MP Hoshayar Korda Kurdish, the Iraqi Parliament's reporter, said in press statements on Monday that more than 100 MPs in the Iraqi parliament submitted a request to the presidency of the parliament to hold the parliament session during the week instead of next Saturday as there is a large mobilization of demonstrations on the 25th of the month present. He added that everything the parliament will do in the interest of the Iraqi street and its tendencies to provide services and jobs and improve the economic reality in the country. The Iraqi government launched a package of decisions to secure billions of dinars to meet the demands of the demonstrators through grants and loans and solve the problem of unemployment and provide thousands of jobs in the armed forces and security services and in other sectors. The Iraqi government did not announce the results of investigations conducted by a high committee headed by the Minister of Planning on the violence that accompanied the demonstrations after it had explicitly declared that the security commanders were not ordered to use live bullets to disperse the demonstrators. MP Sherwin Mirza, a member of the Iraqi parliament, said, "The parliament is going to vote on a number of resolutions that contribute to calm the Iraqi street and the demonstrators. Urgent." It was clear that the demonstrations, which began spontaneously earlier this month in Baghdad and spread rapidly in the central and southern provinces, in their bold slogans exceeded the idea of internal reform adopted by the Iraqi political system in favor of a broader idea up to the demand to bring down the entire political system. Sources confirm that Abdul Mahdi and Helbasi are effectively coordinating all procedural moves aimed at containing the anger of the demonstrators, which is cooled by Saleh, who believes that reform should reach the cornerstones of the political system. The Arab, more articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.